I remember back when I was 4 or 5 years old, holding my dad's hand and watching the legends of the sports.
And it was just gladiators getting in these machines that were so unimaginable that made me want to go out and race.
It's insane what we do, but what makes NHRA racing so special is the intensity.
It's like being a manic depressant. It's just the highs of highs and the lows of lows.
Well, it's perfect for my attention span. It's 3.5 seconds of bad to the bone. I get to 4 seconds and I'm like, ah, squirrel, parachutes, that's it.
I don't care what all these old macho race car drivers tell you what it's like. You are hanging on for your life. You're talking 4 to 5 G's like the space shuttle when it leaves the starting line.
Like being strapped to a rocket, you're getting over 320 miles an hour in just 4 seconds.
You know, it's music to my ears. Once I hear that starter spin over and hit the ignition switch, then it's time to roll.
I get to go do a lot of other racing with some pretty cool race car drivers, some of the best in the world. They'll drive anything, but when you bring them out to a drag race, when you offer them to jump into a 10,000 horsepower funny car like I drive, they shake their head and they said, not a chance.
Whether on the start line or in the stands, the ground shakes underneath you. It's that kind of horsepower that you're feeling. It's unbelievable. It's a runaway freight train.
Cars are animals, so you definitely have to respect them. No matter how comfortable you become or how confident you get, these things will turn around and slap you in the face and make you look stupid.
You got 20 different race teams out here, 20 different crews, 20 different crew chiefs, 20 different drivers, and yet we can come up with almost the same formula and go out on a racetrack and race within a thousandth of a second of each other at over 330 miles an hour.
Cars, I was scared to death. I've, you know, driven super comp cars, I've driven A-fuel cars, but this is a whole different monster.
When I hit the throttle, it parked me in the seat. It shoved me back, and it was a G-force. That thing was carrying the front end, it was trucking.
It's just an unbelievable piece of equipment, and the fact that these crew guys can tear it down, rebuild a motor in just under an hour in between each round is pretty unbelievable.
We're giving the fans pit access to watching these monsters get built, watching them get raced, watching them get torn apart again by the best men and women in the world that work on cars.
Every ticket gets you right in here to the pit area. That's something that's really unique that this sport has to offer over any stick and ball sport and certainly over any other motorsport.
Put my helmet on, and once they sit me in a car and strap me, that's when Antron goes from like I look now to the gladiator face where you get serious and you get in the zone to go do battle.
I want to beat all of them. I even want to beat my own daughter, Courtney, my youngest. She's a real pain to me.
It's always extra gratifying to beat the ones that, you know, are the best out here.
You know, it's easy to win well, but nobody likes losing, and I have a hard time walking over and say, hey, good job beating me, buddy. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to do that. I care too much about it to lose easily like that.
You're about to maybe make history. You're about to maybe time travel. You're maybe about to go out and explode an engine and catch fire. It wasn't until I was almost coasting to a stop that I could hear the safety guys pull up in the truck next to me yelling at me to pull the brake and stop the car. Thank God all the safety stuff worked, but heck of a way to end the night.
When you beat people that already created history, when you beat them, it gives you a little stripe on your belt because you're creating some history yourself. If you're beating the best, what does that make you?
You know, seeing that wind light come on, knowing nobody can pass you in the points, it's over. You're the champion. You know, it doesn't get any finer than that.
You're gifted with that moment, and that moment is huge when you got the right people behind you.
Everybody has to be together on that same page. When you get that perfect unison, that's when championship teams are born.
feeling you get watching one, let alone driving it, that pure awesomeness. I don't know what else to say. It made me want to be a drag racer.
This is the extremest sport on the planet. We're the fastest sport in the world.
The sky's the limit, and I love where it's headed.
This is built for drag racing. Short, effective, and nasty.
There's NASCAR, there's IndyCar, there's F1, there's outlaw racing. I'm not taking anything away from them, but the real difference is drag racing. It's the ride of a lifetime. I always say it's better than sex, but how would I know at my age?